Morning friends, I welcome you all for another lecture on the course Microprocessors and Microcontrollers. From last few classes, I was discussing about the instruction set of 8051 microcontroller. In that, I covered already data transfer instructions, arithmetic instructions, logical instructions. And in this class, I'm going to discuss about another group of instructions called bit manipulation instructions. This is the fourth group of instructions in the instruction set of 8051 microcontroller. And for all this bit manipulation, the name itself indicates, these instructions are used to do the operation directly on bits. I repeat, these instructions are used to do operations directly on bits. So that these are called bit manipulation instructions. The first point about this bit manipulation instructions is, for this bit manipulation instructions, our carry flag is act as accumulator. For bit manipulation instructions, the carry flag is act as accumulator. For byte related operations, we know that accumulator register is nothing but A. In a similarly, for bit manipulation instructions, our carry flag CY is act as accumulator. That is the first point you have to remember. And coming to my second point is, what are the operands for this bit manipulation instructions? Once you remember past classes, that is, once you remember the memory organization of 8051 microcontroller, in internal random access memory, the partition 2 we can call as bit slash byte addressable memory, area of size 16 bytes. In the 16 bytes of bit slash byte addressable area, we may have 128 bits, each and every bit have an address that was a 00H to 7FH. That means for this bit manipulation instructions, one of the option which is used as an operand is the bits which are present in bit slash byte addressable area of our internal random access memory. And the second option is, whatever the registers we identified in 8051, all are not byte addressable registers. Some of them are bit addressable registers. That means, what are the bits those are present in that register, each and every one has its own internal address. So, the second chance or second option, which is used as an operand for this bit manipulation instructions are the bit addressable register bits. So that is second. And coming to the third, what are the different operations we can perform between the bits? If you are thinking that direction, we do go operation, we do logical AND, logical OR, complement, clear and set. These are the different possible operations we performed on bits straight away. Now I am going to discuss the instructions which are present in this one after other. Coming to the first MOV. So, this already we discussed in data transfer instruction. Don't confuse the friends, based on the operands we conclude that MOV instruction is belongs to byte related or it was belongs to bit related. So, MOV is present in this bit manipulation instruction as well as it is in data transfer. Then how can you distinguish? This movie is only belongs to our byte related operation or it is related to bit related operation, that is purely depends on the operand fields. See here friends, here my operand is move C comma bit. So what is the meaning of this? Move the value what I have specified in address bit at a source, that bit value is transferred to carry flag. For better understanding, I write an example. Move C comma some 60H. That means in bit slash byte addressable area of our RAM, whose address is a 60H, what is the value that was present in that address, that bit value is moved to carry flag C1. For example, the value that was present in a bit address 60H is equal to 1. After execution of this move C comma 60H, what happens is our carry flag also loaded with logic 1. And already told you friends, that is our carry flag is act as accumulator for bit related instructions that we know. And coming to the second one is ANL. Again, this ANL is nothing but AND logical. This instruction will already find it logical instructions of 8051. Again, the same ANL operation code we find in this bit manipulation instruction. Then how can you be distinguishes? Again, based on observing the operand fields. What are the operand fields that ANL instruction have? Based on that, we conclude that instruction is belongs to bit manipulation instructions or it was belongs to logical instructions. So, if I consider an example, ANL C, bit, that means do logical AND between carry flag and addressed bit. Again, if I consider an example, ANL space C, some 70H, that means whatever the address that is a 70H have a bit value. The bit value is logical AND with carry flag CY. The final result again stored on to carry flag itself. So like this we can identify. And one more variant we find in this ANL instruction. It is not there in our byte related logical instructions. That was ANL C, bit prime or bit bar. So the meaning of this one is before doing a logical AND between a carry and addressed bit, first you can go on to complement for addressed bit. Later only the complemented version of addressed bit is logical AND with carry. Write an example, ANL space C, ANL space C, 70H bar or a prime. That means before doing a logical AND between a carry and the bit address 70H, first you have to go and take a complement for the value what I was found in 70H bit address. Later the produced result is a logical AND with a carry. Let you can assume friends, for example, before execution of this instruction, our carry flag value is equal to 1 and our 70H bit address value is 0. Before doing the logical AND between this and this, first I have to go and take complement for 70H bit. So if I did it, then it will become 1. Then I do logical AND between a carry and this 70H prime or a bar. Then what happens? 1 is logical AND with a 1, resultant is 1, that 1 goes to carry flag itself. This type of variant we never find in logical instruction set of our 8051. So that is about ANL space C, bit prime. Now similarly, we have one more instruction is ORL. ORL means or logical. Again, this instruction also we find in logical instructions of 8051. But again, how we can distinguish ORL is doing operation on a bits or a bytes? Again, by observing the operand fields. So see here friends, my example is ORL space C, bit. That means do logical OR between carry flag and addressed bit. Carry flag and addressed bit. So result again stored on to carry flag itself. Again, one more variant is ORL space C, bit prime. The meaning of that is again do logical OR between a carry and addressed bit complement. That means before doing a logical OR, first you can go and took a complement for addressed bit. Later the result is logical OR with carry flag and result again stored into carry flag itself. It is looks like our logical AND operation. Only the difference between ORL C, bit prime and ANL space C, bit prime. In ANL C, bit prime I was doing logical AND, but coming to ORL space C, bit prime means logical AND. Everything is same. And next coming to my next instruction is CBL means complement. CBL means complement. We can do this complement either on carry flag value or we can do this complement on address bit. There are two options. That means we can do complement on either carry flag, or it may be done on a specific address bit. The same CPL we find in logical instructions of 8051 instruction set. But there our operand always is accumulated. But now here is our operand is either carry flag or it may be an address bit. For example, if I take us a first one CPLC, before execution of that instruction, my carry flag value 0. My carry flag value was 0 before execution of my instruction CPL space C. But after execution of that, the same carry flag value was complemented. Due to that, your carry flag value becomes logic 1. So this is the scenario. So similarly, if I go for one more example, CPL space bit. So CPL space some 60H, if I write like this, CPL space 60H. So 60H is an address of bit. Let you then assume before execution of this instruction, the bit value that was present in 60H is logical 1. After execution of CPL space 60H, the value becomes 0. The 0 was stored in 60H itself. So that is about this. And next one is CLR. CLR means clear. CLR means clear. Again, this CLR is used to clear the carry flag value or specified address limit. You can clear the carry flag or specified address limit. So if I go and take a CLRC means clear carry, that means after execution of CLRC, the carry flag value becomes 0. And similarly, CLR space bit, that means clear the specified address bit. That means the specified address bit is loaded with 0 by execution of CLR space bit instruction. By execution of CLR C instruction, the carry flag CY is loaded with 0. So that is about this. And next one is SCTB. SCTB means SCD represents set and B represents bit. Set bit. By using this instruction, we can set a carry flag or we can set any address bit. So this SCTB instruction is opposite to clear instruction. What the clear instruction can do? The clear instruction clears the carry flag value or the specified address bit value. Now SCTB, what it do? It will set the carry flag value by 1 or it will set the specified address bit value 1. So here by execution of SCTBC, that means by execution of this instruction, that means set bit carry flag, the carry flag CY is loaded with logic 1. In a similarly, SCTB space bit means by execution of that instruction, the specified bit is initializing with logic 1 or loaded with logic 1. That is the meaning of SCTB space bit. So these are my possible bit manipulation instructions that I was found in 8051 instruction set. So in these all cases, one thing is very clear, friends. For this bit manipulation instructions, the carry flag plays a vital role. It is act as the accumulator for all bit manipulation instructions. I hope you understand this concept. In the next class, I am going to discuss about another concept, the instruction set of 8051. So thank you for patient listening. We will meet in next class.